This is a council estate in London, between Battersea Park Road and the railway, built by Wandsworth Borough Council. 28 blocks, population over 7,000 people. Today, no more people live here than when all this was slums. The new shapes look tidy and well-disposed, but it's the people inside them who have to call them a home, who have to find a sense of belonging.
As soon as I get up, I usually put the kettle on for a cup of tea as first, and then I dodge round and do me a little bit of work. And then about 10 o'clock, I go for a little walk all round, do a bit of shopping, which takes me about an hour and a half. And then I come back again, have a bit of lunch, and then do little odds and ends. And then by that time, the television starts. I start watching television about 4:30 until about 12 o'clock. And then I go to bed. That's all my entertainment, really. That's the only thing I've got. Because I only see my family. My daughter once in about 6 weeks because she lives so far away. And of course, I have the wireless as well, but I prefer television. It doesn't seem so lonely. You feel somehow you've got somebody in the room.
Side of the whole estate at the present moment looks new, but I think that in a 2, 3, 4 years, I'm afraid it's going to look exactly like our street looked from the outside. It's gradually, even now, changing from when we first came in here. I was listening to Woman's Hour. I'd only been here about a month, and I wasn't really listening to Woman's Hour, but I suddenly heard this. I think it was Barbara Cartland. I think it was her. I wasn't really interested till I heard what she said. She started talking about the £6.5 million project in the Battersea Park Road, and she said to me, it screams out of slums. Oh, I was really, really indignant. I just moved in here. I don't know now. I think maybe she was right, you know. There's a lot to be said for giving people a decent place to live in. I don't know who designs them. I don't know who they design them for, or if they think that we feel or think any differently than they do. There must be reasons why these architects build these flats in this design and this hard, barrack-looking way, because I'm sure they couldn't possibly like the structure and the outlook of them themselves. I don't think there was an awful lot of thought put into it. If they would have only consulted ordinary people who have to live in these places, what we would like, it's not a lot we would like, but we do like the same things as they enjoy. They like the outside of their places to look nice, and so do we. We don't differ in any way to them. Surely that in time somebody will learn to come and ask the ordinary people what they'd like and how they would like them.